a fiddler on the roof. Sounds crazy, no? But here in our little village of Anatevka, you might say that every one of us is a fiddler on the roof, trying to scratch out a pleasant, simple tune without breaking his neck. It isn't easy. You may ask, why do we stay up there if it's so dangerous? Well, we stay because Anatevka is our home. And how do we keep our balance? That I can tell you in one word. Tradition.
My name's Jerry Pfaff.
Currently at my childhood home in Maryland.
In these days of confused situations, in these nights of a restless remorse, when the heart and the soul of a nation lay wounded.
Shortly after I graduated from college, somebody showed me a poster from Wycliffe Bible Translator. It was a help wanted poster, but it showed the needs of Bible translation around the world. And I had trained to be a high school math teacher, but I said, Lord, there's people fighting over teaching jobs in the U.S. This is obviously a job that needs people, and there aren't enough people to go around. And if you want me to change my plans, I'll go and do that work if you want me to. So I put my career choice on the altar, and I told God he'd have to open the doors for me, and he just kept swinging doors wide open and brought us to Papua New Guinea. We came in 1987 and we looked at some of the places where there were needs, and an administrator pushed us strongly in the direction of Manus Island. It's kind of good that he did, because if we had gone out there and looked at it first and realized what a beautiful place it is, we might have chosen it for the wrong reasons. We've been there working mainly with the Nali speaking people on Manus Island in Manus province to the north of the mainland of Papua New Guinea.
Every debt that you ever had has been paid up in full by the grace of the Lord.
These little language groups, unless somebody comes in and helps them, they'll never get a Bible in their language, and I think they're still deserving of knowing God's word and having God communicate directly to them in the language that speaks to their heart.
Water, giving hope in a storm sea of night, be a refuge.
So we ended up in the place that we feel God wants us, and we just responded and said, we're available.
I know you are busy, God. Wars and revolutions, floods, plagues, all those little things that bring people close to you. But couldn't you take a second away from your catastrophes and help him to get the sewing machine? How much trouble would it be? Oh, and while you're in the neighborhood, my horse, his left leg is... Am I bothering you too much? I'm sorry. As the good book says, why should I tell you what the good book says?
When we think about the people who don't have access to God's word the way we do, I wonder how they get by sometimes. I look to the Bible when I need help and encouragement and wisdom and comfort. And there's all kinds of times when my father died or when grief comes along and pains and problems, that we turn to the Word for guidance and help. And people who don't have that, I think they are missing out not only on the opportunity to have a relationship with God if they don't understand how they can do that, but just all the wisdom that comes from His Word. And so I want to see everybody in the world have access to that. And so we really love what we do and are thankful for the opportunity to do this job. And it keeps us going every day. It's an amazing time that we live in, and we're really pleased to be a part of what God is doing in Bible translation and making scriptures available around the world. But we want to leave more than just a book. We want to leave disciples and people who are trained and able to continue on. We may not get the whole Bible done in our lifetime. We're hoping to get at least the whole New Testament done. We don't know if we'll live long enough to see the whole Old Testament done, but if we leave trained Papua New Guineans behind, they can certainly finish out that work after we're gone. But we hope to publish at least a New Testament and portions from the Old Testament in a big volume someday, plus trained translators who'll be able then to continue to go and finish the Old Testament or do as much translation as they want and are motivated and able to do. My main role has been to mentor and train and to do the exegetical checks in Nali, but we're also working with other teams now and doing computer work and consulting for the Nali people and others as they gain new skills.
Our Lord commands the sea and gives His people victory. Leads us by cloud and fire, but many areas of God admire. The ones we fear have now all disappeared. We're free!
Day and age, and it's amazing what you can do even way off the grid. Never a dull moment in a sense. There's all kinds of things going on all the time. There's still cultural things that we have to learn and blunders that we make, and we turn around and laugh at ourselves and go on. But it's never a humdrum day, and I don't get up every morning and dread a long commute to the office, because I just have enjoyed for the whole time we've been here the work of getting God's Word into the languages of Papua New Guinea. We never have a typical day. Work is always new and it's always interesting. Even the hard parts are sometimes interesting just because they're different. We don't have any typical days. What keeps us motivated? Somebody once said, if you find something you love to do, you'll never work a day in your life.
First shave.
I haven't done this side yet.
Since you left, thought maybe I'd start a little video blog for you. We haven't got the man.
Mazel tov.
We had when we began.
Mazel tov.
But since your grandma came, she'll marry, what's his name?
The tailor motto comes oil.
The tailor motto comes oil. The tailor motto comes oil. The tailor motto comes oil. Thank you.
your wife.
I know. But do you love me?
Do I love him? For 25 years I've lived with him. Fought with him, starved with him. 25 years my bed is his. If that's not love, what is?
Then you love me. And I suppose I love you too. It doesn't change a thing, but even so, after 25 years, it's nice to know.
Has been our number one support role because she's the one that keeps everything going. Boy, I'm sure glad that God gave me a partner who has so many skills. She's great.
We are so grateful for the people who have stood by us for our whole time on the field and the people who have joined along the way, and we're just so grateful. We felt like God specifically sent us to Papua New Guinea and that He specifically sent us to Manus Island to work with the Nali people and with other languages.
Just listen to what I'm whispering to your heart. I know this is not anything like you thought the story of your life was gonna be. And it feels like the end has started closing in on you, but it's just not true. There's so much of the story that's still yet to unfold. And this
you may talk, thank you, Lord Papa God, because now the translation program has long and he no stop long you me man. He no stop long me, or long Luke, or long David Dryo, or long Martha, or long who's that. Even though all that you me playing part long you me yet. Get the glory by God on Papa God, because I'm hasplong talkless nally, na hasplong book Bible now today, I come long talkless. Thank you.
There's so much of the story that's still yet to unfold. And this is going to be a glorious unfold. For this world and your heart has been to show His glory and His grace, forever revealing
the depth and the beauty of His unfailing love. And the story has only begun, and this is going to be a glorious unfolding. Just you wait and see, and you will be amazed. We've just got to believe the story is so far from over. So hold on to every promise God has made. Savior and King, so let us remember this life we're living is just the beginning of the beginning.
It's exciting to be a part of doing something that you know counts for eternity. I would hate to get up someday and wonder if I've lived my life and there's nothing to show for it at the end. Since we're investing in God's Word and people, we know that our life is not wasted and we're doing things that matter. And so it's motivating to get up and work each day. And we look forward to seeing the fruit that God provides. We're just gardeners in His great orchard, and the fruit is His. And someday we'll have the privilege of standing around God's throne, worshiping with people from every tribe and tongue and people and nation. What greater motivation can you have? What greater goal can you be living for?